right, Gene, thanks a lot. Eddie Guerrero, as Gene said, later on against Dean Malenko, one-on-one here on WCW Saturday night. If there was any defining moment for Eddie Guerrero, I think, what he's made of, that is what happened at the Clash of the Champions when he lost to Chris Jericho, but then proceeded to attack the man from behind.
Yeah, he was outraged at that loss, and he really took that other step over the line of really trying to hurt somebody. So many things happened at the Clash of Champions. Mongo McMichael, United States Heavyweight Wrestling Champion. We've seen tremendous night that really told the story about what's going on here with the Sting Hogan thing. And you know what you said earlier, too? NWO, WCW, that wall's coming to a head inside that huge steel cage at Wall Games Only on pay-per-view.
Who's going to be on the team? Yet to be decided, but when you look down the roster for both the NWO and for WCW, you've got the greatest athletes in our sport on either side, and it has the makings, not only because of the athletes, but because of the battleground and the tension and the war for one of the most exciting events of the year.
You call it like you see it, and you told it like it was, and that's just as simple as it is. The greatest athletes in the world are here at WCW where the big boys play. Make no mistake about it. And here are two right here. This young man, Hugh Morrus, got all the talent, speed, and power that anyone, you know, could take into that square circle. Rick Fuller now has been on the hunt. He's been a guy that's been on the hunt, been close to the pay window, been close to getting the victory. And he's not going to back down here from Mr. Hugh Morrus. This is a good one right here.
He really has two of the biggest and strongest that we have here in WCW at this time. And as you said, he's in the hunt. And right now, Rick Fuller, knife-edge chop on Hugh Morrus, caught in the corner. How about that? Not many people have been able to do that against this 300-pounder named Hugh Morrus. Into the corner, and he comes with a lariat, and that spilled Rick Fuller onto the mat.
Yeah, that's called payback, too. He was beating on him real good. We were talking about him, and Hugh Morrus just had enough to come on back strong with that thing right here. But Fuller reverses it, comes back around.
Whoa, boy.
What a move for a big man.
A big move for a big man. Fans, as we've been talking about, and as you know by watching WCW Monday Nitro on TNT, there is no question. The word is out. The message is loud and clear. And the message was punctuated two nights ago at the Clash of the Champions that there is one and one thing only that Sting wants to be able to get back in the ring, and that is Hulk Hogan. Hollywood Hulk Hogan. It's now up to James J. Dillon to get this done.
Yeah, the committee now. You know, the fans have spoken. Sting has, in a way, spoken. You know, Hollywood Hulk Hogan, the NWO, when they were celebrating the big party, when it was interrupted by this unbelievable scene that we witnessed live, if you will, right here on the Superstation this past Thursday night. Really something, I guarantee you. And this wall is going to be something inside these steel cages pay-per-view. Nitro coming up. I hope, you know, with what we talked about with Eric, looked like he was reading something there in the middle of the ring, and we talked about that situation. Hopefully this Monday on TNT Monday Nitro, that thing will clear up a little bit on what that note was all about. But I guarantee it had everybody scared there on the NWO side. You know what I'm saying? So, whoa! What I'm saying here, too, if Hugh Morrus had worked it out for him here, this ain't been no easy task. All right, let me get a break here. You know, I just put the filibustering on because I want to know what was in the note, you know.
I think it's pretty clear what was in the note.
Well, I know it, and it was clear to them, but
yes.
You've seen the eyes turn to fear. I've seen men turn to fear.
Well, when James J. Dillon on Nitro says, you got to the Clash to tell us what you want, when Sting picks up a sign that says Sting versus Hulk,
yeah.
You know there.
Yeah.
And then when Sting comes out at the end of the Clash, when they are celebrating their one-year birthday party,
yeah.
And here comes this vulture or whatever down from the heavens,
oh, yeah.
And drops apparently something to Eric Bischoff.
Bad cloud.
What else could it be?
Yeah. Whoa, got him too. What a move that was.
No laughing matter, and it's not for Rick Fuller. This one is over.
Hey. Yeah, that vulture, as you said, left a real bad cloud over the house of the NWO.
Yes,
you could see it on their face, and you covered it all, and that's what went down. But with 10, 20,000 fans are holding up
just
signs.
Just because it's fucking for me.
But Stephen Hogan, that should tell you something right off. James J. maybe was a little stubborn on trying to. Maybe he can't read with his glasses he got.
Well, I don't know. And, here it is again, Drake.
Well, it's just very simply a powerful young man with a lot of talent right here in the mix, in the hunt, now to the pay window. no laughing matter. As a matter of fact, this guy is good right here on Saturday night.
Hugh Morrus is your winner. Still to come, much more action on Superstation TBS.